Settlers' Gain is Sigmar's foremost fortress city in the Realm of Light. And in this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the uniform and heraldry of the troops that hail from this city. All the paints you'll need for this guide are on screen now, but remember that you can paint your miniatures however you like. The paints we're using here are just our suggestions. Also on screen now is any additional equipment we've used. This includes brushes and mediums. However, please feel free to use whatever brushes you're most comfortable with. And if you don't have any mediums at home, you could use water instead. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about painting Warhammer. We'll be showing you how to paint the tunic and shield of this city on a free guild steel helm. And to start off with, we need to undercoat our miniature. We've chosen Wraithbone as a nice warm undercoat. So to start off with, we'll be painting the shield, and we'll start off with a base coat of a Latok blue. With any layer paints, it's always a good idea to thin them down with some water. We'll apply multiple thin layers rather than one thick layer. Now, even though this is a layer paint, we can still use this to base coat with. We might just need to do an extra layer or two. For this, we can use something like a small base brush. We don't need to worry about being neat, but just be careful to get into all those tricky to reach areas. And don't forget to paint the back of the shield too. If we applied a thick layer, this might clog up all that fine detail. Once that's dry, we can apply a shade all over the shield, and for this we'll be using Drakenhof Nightshade. If you find the shade is pooling too much in any of the recesses, clean off your brush and use that to soak up the excess. Again, don't worry about being neat. We'll be painting all the other details later anyway. This is a really nice dark blue shade, so it'll add plenty of depth to the recesses. The next thing we're going to do is dry brush the wood, and for this we're going to use Fenrisian Grey and a small dry brush. We're using a smaller brush here so that we can get into all those tricky areas. When we're dry brushing, it's important to remove as much paint off our brush as possible, so you can work it off onto something like a paper towel or a piece of cardboard. We want to just leave a small amount of paint on those bristles. Then we can move the brush over the raised detail on our miniature. Doing this creates a soft and subtle highlight. It also helps to make the wood look quite worn and adds a weathering effect, so it looks like our shield has really seen some action on the battlefield. Now we'll be adding a metallic detail. We'll be painting the trim using Retributor Armour. This is a very rich gold, so it'll look quite bright, but we'll be adding a shade over it later to help make it look much more aged. Here you might want to use something like a small layer brush, as this will give us a little bit more control. We want to try and be as neat as we possibly can here, as we've already spent some time painting the other details. However, don't worry if you make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up by following the previous steps. Once that trim's painted, we can see that that shield is already starting to take shape. Now we'll be painting the centre of the shield using Wraithbone. If your shield's got any parchment on it, we can also use this colour for that too. Again, we'll need to thin this down and apply a few thin layers. Make sure you allow each layer to fully dry before you move on to the next one. If we try and layer over paint that isn't quite dry, this could create texture on our miniature. Now we'll be adding a contrast paint over that trim, and this will help to make it look really aged and battle-worn. For this, we'll be using Gore Grunter Fur, but we'll be thinning it down with some contrast medium. So we'll be using 2 parts contrast medium to 1 part Gore Grunter Fur. And the reason for thinning this down is so that it's a little bit more subtle and doesn't overpower that base coat quite so much. It also helps the paint to flow more easily. Again, just keep an eye out for any excess pooling. Now we'll add some age to that parchment and the centre of the shield, and for this we'll be using Skeleton Horde. If we applied this straight from the pot, it would be a little bit too strong over such a pale base coat, so again we'll be thinning this down with some contrast medium. We'll be using 2 parts contrast medium to 1 part Skeleton Horde and mixing that together on our palette. Don't worry if it seems to dry a little bit unevenly, this all adds to the aged and weathered effect. Now, if you'd like to add an extra stage to really take this paint job up a notch, we can add an edge highlight to the trim. We'll be using Iron Hand Steel for this. So we'll be using a small layer brush so that we've got the most control over our paint. Make sure that you've got a good point on your brush at all times. We'll need to thin this paint down a little. We'd like it to glide effortlessly off the brush, but we don't want it to be too watery as this won't settle on the miniature correctly. Just take your time and work your way around the trim, using the edge of your brush to highlight those edges wherever you can. Don't worry if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the previous steps. You'll see that this really adds to the overall weathered and aged look that we're going for. And if you'd like to add a highlight to the center of the shield too, we can use Wraithbone for this. Follow the same steps as before, just taking your time and being as neat as you possibly can. Again, mistakes can always be tidied up, so don't worry too much. This particular section in the center of the shield is really good as it's quite a raised detail. This allows us to move the miniature around and get the best angle to use the edge of our brush to do the highlight. Highlighting in this way is really quick and easy and results in very crisp highlights. And with that stage done, you can see our shield is finished and looking battle-worn. Now we'll show you how to paint the model's tunic. So for the first step on painting the tunic, we'll be using Calidor Sky. This is a lovely bright blue which complements that shield really nicely. Again, this is a base paint, so we need to thin it down and apply a few thin layers. We don't need to worry too much about being neat here, just make sure you get into all the tricky to reach areas. It's up to you what size brush you prefer to use here. We're using a small base brush, but it might be easier to switch to a smaller one for those more intricate areas. Next, we'll be using Drakenhof Nightshade again, and we'll be applying that all over the tunic. We can apply this in just the same way we did with the shield. Apply it heavily and neatly, being careful to control that pooling. It's also a good idea to work in small sections, as this avoids the paint drying out too quickly anywhere, as this could leave an inconsistent finish on our miniatures. This paint will add lots of depth to the recesses and slightly change the colour of the blue, which helps to complement that blue shield. And if you'd like to add an edge highlight to the tunic, we can use Rust Grey for this. Again, we'll be using a small layer brush so that we've got more control. Make sure you've got a stable painting position and don't be scared to move the miniature around as much as you need to get the best angles for those highlights. Just take your time and work your way around, picking out as many edges as you like. And if you make any mistakes, don't worry, just thin down some Calidor Sky and use that to go back over the mistake. And there we have it. Now you know how to paint that regal blue of the Settlers' Gain troops. You can apply the technique shown to any Cities of Sigmar miniatures that you'd like to paint in these colours. We've applied a transfer to the shield just to finish it off. And if you'd like to learn more about using transfers, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Or head on over to citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!